entrance is number 558. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings we bear to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters and sons of him, who build the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We come before our God, mindful of the salvation that has been won for us by Christ. Mindful, too, of the times we have sinned, as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power, above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, Abraham did not doubt God's promise in unbelief. Rather, he was empowered by faith and gave glory to God, and was fully convinced that what God had promised, he was able to do. That is why it was credited to him as righteousness, but it was not for him alone that it was written and that it was credited to him. It was also for us, to whom it will be credited. Who believe in the one who raised Jesus, our Lord, from the dead, who was handed over for our transgressions and was raised for our justification. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people.
He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people.
Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people.
This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship without fear, holy in righteousness in his sight all the days of our life.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people.
Someone in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to share the inheritance with me." He replied to him, "Friend, who appointed me as your judge and arbitrator?" Then he said to the crowd, "Take care to guard against all greed, for though one may be rich, one's life does not consist of possessions." Then he told them a parable. There was a rich man whose land produced a bountiful harvest. He asked himself, "What shall I do? I shall tear down my barns and build larger ones. There I shall store all my grain and other goods, and I shall say to myself, 'Now as for you, you have so many good things stored up for many years. Rest, eat, drink, be merry.' God said to him, 'You fool, this night your life will be demanded of you, and the things you have prepared, to whom will they belong? Thus will it be for the one who stores up treasure for himself, but is not rich in what matters to God.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Perhaps a good example of that gospel might be if you looked in my refrigerator and if you opened some of the containers and you saw things that might be green, a little fuzzy. Not that I'm storing them up, but it's just, you know, I don't need that much. So by the time I get to it, well, some of it may have been expired. The whole point there is, what is it that we hold on to? What is it that we cling to? You know, as human persons, our minds are expansive, but not that expansive. In other words, our whole field of reference, if you will, is this life. You know, perhaps we remember some childhood things, perhaps some teenage things, perhaps some adult things, whatever the case might be. That's our field of reference. And so those very happy moments, certainly we hold close and would love to repeat them. Those sad moments, we also hold close. We don't necessarily want to repeat them, but that's our field of reference. And what Jesus is inviting us to do is to expand that field of reference. You know, just in visiting some of our shut-ins and our older members, you know, time after time after time, the question comes up, you know, "Well, Father, what do you think heaven's going to be like? What do you think eternity's going to be like?" And, you know, I don't have an answer that's an exact description. I don't think any of us does. But the fact of the matter is, what I invite them to do is I want you to think of the happiest moment in your life. Now, multiply that by billions. That's what I think it's going to be like. I mean, we can't even begin to comprehend what awaits us. Perhaps sometimes it's fearful to cross through that door. But on the other hand, it's like, you know, God's not going to disappoint. Never going to disappoint. So in this life, what we need to do is we need to prepare for that. And it's not so much possessions that we cling to, but there's so many other things in our lives that we cling to that prevent us from growing that vision, if you will, believing in that expansive eternity. Jesus invites us to do just that. Don't cling to what's not going to last, but be open to all eternity. Ever confident in God's care for us, we raise our voice in prayer.
For the church, that the church may be empowered by faith to give glory to God as of Abraham, who raised Jesus from the dead, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That wealthy nations may be protected from the temptations of greed and be blessed with the generosity of spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who struggle with doubt and insecurity in the presence of the Lord may be blessed with abundant joy and faith in the confidence of God's promises. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this community of faith may be rich in what matters to God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, especially Arv Arbison, Kelly Castle, John Tartarina, Agnes Clark, Mary Dunkey, James Fairhead, Danny Firth, Ross Firth, Daisha Furtney, Robert Jayett, Julianne Jenkins, Dan Lane, Mary Lombardo, Tom Murkowski, Lynn Mattingly, Chloe Pascal, Greg Rich, Carol Scaley, Paula Simmons, Kaylin Tafini, Tina Testa. For the victims and survivors of abuse in our church and beyond, for accountability, justice, and healing throughout our church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have gone before us in the light of faith may receive the inheritance of eternal life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who have recently died, and for Tom Hedrick, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions that remain deep in the silence of our hearts and minds, for those written in our prayer minutes book, and for those we have been asked to pray for through our renewal recommitment initiative, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We continue to pray in the Dublin prayer, the synod in Rome, and the guidance of the Spirit and the fruit that it will bear, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for an end to the conflict, not only in the Ukraine, but especially at this time in Israel and Palestine, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Ever faithful God, hear us as we pray for these things and all, in the name of your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, fruit of the vine and the work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in his fullness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself, and by the blood of his cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith, when we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Edward our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Remember your word to your servant, O Lord, by which you have given me hope. This is my comfort when I am brought low. Body. heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing is number 558, verse 2.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. In his wisdom he strengthens us like gold that's tested in fire.